We just had the big bombshell announcement from Sarah here. But last night, Peter Helliar had his own announcement.
Everyone's doing it.
Yeah, everyone's doing it. I'm leaving. Oh, no. He is leaving the project next month.
I look forward to see what the show is in the future. I'm pretty sure there's no more announcements. And Waleed, I can't wait to see what you and Colin Jackie O do with the show next year.
I thought everybody
knew. But no, there's things I want to do. I need to put more effort into my OnlyFans account. And
Pete joined the show as a permanent host in January 2014. And the very funny man joins us now. It's Pete Helliar, everyone! Yay!
Hello. Hello, sir. Hey, Tristan. How are we?
I've just got to ask, Pete. Was it something I said?
I swear to you, Sarah Harris, it is nothing personal. It is a coincidence that this is happening within a few hours of our announcements. But no, I just want to say to you, Sarah, I was thrilled when I heard it was you replacing, you know, Carrie. Obviously, big shoes to fill, but you have big feet. And you are going to be amazing. I've seen you work up close and personal, both at Studio 10 when I've been a guest in the studio, but also when you've been on the desk with us at the project, and you are going to just fit right in. And
thank you so much. But Samoy's not about me, it's about you. And we want to talk about your time, because you're so loved on the project. Was it hard for you to step away, because you've been there for 8 years?
Yeah, it has been a long time, and I guess every contract that I've signed, you always think, you know, do I want to go around again? And most contracts, it's been a pretty short conversation, to be honest. And but this one, I think this year I was starting to think, you know, about a few other things. And when Carrie kind of went away and then kind of came back, and I kind of maybe thought maybe I'll sneak away for a few months next year. And then Carrie said something that was really interesting to me. She said, "I'm glad I'm leaving the show while I still love it." Really resonated. And the fact that I was thinking about taking some time off, or you know, really looking at other projects a bit more seriously, just made me think, I don't want to fall out of love with this show. I love it. I'm really proud of it. I'm excited for its future. And it's time for me to explore other things.
Wow. And you've been hilarious on it, and we love you. And another thing, they say always leave people with wanting more, and we definitely want more from you, Peter. You have a regular Wednesday segment, Viral Wednesday. You've had a lot of different segments over the years. Do you remember this segment here?
I got a new segment, guys. I'm pretty excited about it. It's time for
Pete's Ironic Name.
It's like rain on your wedding day.
I actually don't.
It's probably for the best. Hey, but we're just going to show you what that segment was all about. Yeah, stand by.
Please do.
Please,
there was this fed-up commuter dealing with a strike action at Melbourne Airport, and yes, she has an ironic name.
So he's crying, and they also, they didn't let me go first and ask them to help, and no one helped. And I'm just very, very angry.
Yeah, what's your name? Sorry?
Joy.
Joy?
Yeah.
And that was Pete's Ironic Names.
It's a free ride when you're already...
there were some segments that only ran once, and I think that was one of them. There was one called Gator Clot, where it was hijinks based around gates. That only ran out 3 times. So they weren't all Viral Wednesdays or nuts or life in lockdowns. There were some ones that were more spare.
Yeah, so I'm assuming that won't make a return before you leave the project.
Yeah. Well, Sarah, if you want to continue, I hand you... It can be Sarah's Ironic Names in 2023.
We want to take the crack as well if you want.
Well, yeah, the crack, that was a segment that got like three showings on our show and then disappeared forever. Hey, we want to talk about your crabs.
Yes, and this is why I'm leaving, to be honest. It became an HR issue.
It's actually a new book that you have about Herman Crab. Tell us about it.
Yeah, this is a book that I kind of came up with in lockdown. It's called Herman Crab. Beautiful illustrations by Matt Shanks. He's such a talented illustrator. And I just kind of in lockdown was thinking about, you know, connecting with people and feeling the need to reconnect and what that means. And so I started, you know, I kind of came up with this character, Herman Crab, who, believe it or not, is a hermit crab. And yeah, he discovers that he's got a cousin, Sandy, who happens to be a sand crab, and that he learns to maybe share his life and share that it's good to have friends and family, and it's actually really, really important. But it's also important to have your own space, so he finds the right balance. But I really fell in love with this little guy, and like I said, Matt did a great job with illustrations. There's some lovely gags in there for both kids and adults. There's a point where Herman Crabbe is watching his favourite TV show, Downton Crabbe. and my publisher did say, well, the kids probably won't know what Downton Crabbe is. So I said, well, that joke's for the parents. You know, they're reading as well. So it's a balance. It's a balance.
Oh, and it's good. A lovely book about loneliness and friendships. And how's the timing? Because you're not only bidding farewell to a show by leaving the project, you're saying goodbye to mates that you're seeing every day as well.
And that is the really... I mean, there'll be stuff... I mean, like I said last night, I interviewed Luke Skywalker because of this show. You know, Magic Johnson, LeBron James, Francis Ford Coppola. It's been like... That's been amazing. But it's the friendships I've made along the way with people who maybe I wouldn't have met, you know. I barely knew Waleed before I started the show. So even someone like Steve Price, you know. I just don't see how we would have forged a friendship outside of doing a show like the project together. And, you know, Rachel Corbett and Tony Armstrong, Jesse Stevens, you know, these people who are still coming into my life. And that's the really beautiful thing about being on this show and you know, what you're going to really enjoy about it, Sarah. And, yeah, that's probably what I'll miss the most.
Oh, well, we're going to miss you an awful lot. Yeah, you're going to be a huge loss, but we can't wait to see what you do next. And Herman Crabbe by Peter Helliar is out right now. Pete, thanks so much for taking the time for us today. You're really going to be missed. Best of luck with everything.
Thanks, legend.
No worries at all. I'll see you in Ramsey Street in 23-3.
I think.